I'm Geneva, keeper of the interfaith Dharma Path Kuni, together with Youth Buddhism Communications. Welcome. From different corners of the earth, two continents and two oceans coincide to bring us this Dharma event with two distinctive Dharma speakers whose names resonate and exemplify the two principal guiding footprints in Buddhism. Changci Fa Si. Ci means compassion, altruism. Chang Rei Fa Si. Rei expresses point-to-point lucid wisdom. Ocean is often used in Buddhist writings and suttas to symbolize and help understand the depth and latitude of Buddha wisdom and compassion. The entitylessness, the fluid reflex, and the benevolent nature. As one drop of water disappears in the ocean, reciprocates the penetration of self in the Sangha, that which is the hallmark of the prestigious Fuyen Buddhist College. Before our privilege to attest the noble qualities and the perfection of scholarships in the speakers, we have a Director Wei Kei of Youth Buddhist Communications to authenticate the address welcome in Chinese. She is a legend and institution in herself.
谢谢池达法师的跟我们先做一个英文的介绍。今天非常非常的高兴，也是很荣幸。 我们能够安排在美国的高级学府库里，就是纽约私立大学研究院的这么大的一个地方，然后给我们呢介绍中国，也是大乘佛法。我们很高兴呢邀请呢来自台湾的长慈法师以及呢常瑞法师。 因为刚才池德法师已经讲得很清楚了，我就简单的用中文来介绍一下，以表示我们的诚意跟那个欢迎。首先，长慈法师呢，他2000年呢是一直后官院长出家的。那在13年的时候呢，他已经完成了在澳洲薛里大学。 所进行的佛学相关的研究，而且呢拿到博士的学位，现在呢在台湾的福岩佛学院做教授。那么今天法师会跟大家介绍的呢是大乘佛法的精神啊，特别呢他把这个大乘佛法的精神呢如何放在我们的生活里面、修行里面。 然后另外一会呢，是也是来自福岩佛学院的，是常瑞法师。常瑞法师呢，他是花果山的佛学院硕士班3年级，他专门研究的呢是敦煌，而且呢还研究那个《阿含经》。 大家呢常常会看到呢那个印存文教基金会出版有一本呢叫《福慧随身书》，像上线很多人都有。那这个系列呢也是常瑞法师呢把它抽成一个小本啊，然后呢宣传给我们呢现代人可以随时可以运用，随时可以学习的。那今天呢常瑞法师呢他会介绍的是我们七月农历七月非常关心的法门，就是地藏法门跟忏悔法门。这个呢也是。 希望在这个月啊，是佛教的那个孝月哈，所以呢，也在今天我们有机会好好的学习啊，现在我们热烈的掌声先欢迎常慈法师。
Good evening, venerables and Dharma friends. It's a pleasure to be here to share with you some Dharma teaching. It's nice to see so many have to chosen their Thursday night listen to the Dharma. You are all very wise. I was asked to give a Chinese translation, so I will give it English first and then Chinese. Hope some English audience don't mind of it. 诸位长老以及诸位法师慈悲，还有诸位在家菩萨，大家晚上好。那很荣幸，很欢喜有这个因缘来到纽约跟大家分享这个佛法。那今天的主题呢是这个大乘佛教的一个精神啊。那也很高兴看到那么多人来今天晚上。那想大家是非常有智慧来熏习佛法哈。So today I would like to talk about the spirit of Mahayana and highlight what it means in our practice using the example of Queen Sri Mala's 10 Great Vows. So, 所以今天我要谈的这个主题是这个大乘实践的一个精神，那主要着重在它如何应用在我们的一个生活的修行上啊。那将会用这个圣曼夫人的十大愿来作为一个例子，然后来跟大家分享如何来应用这个大乘佛法精神在我们的生活当中。So firstly, I would like to share with you the saying, which I feel feel fully embodies the spirit of Mahayana practice. I have translated it from Chinese, and it means to purify and tame physical and mental activities, bring benefit to all sentient beings.首先呢要跟大家分享的是一个这是印顺法师在他一本书里面所提示我们给我们的一个教导，那就是静置身心利济有情啊。This saying has two levels. On the personal level,we should develop ourselves so that our activities and speech are pure, wholesome, and ethical. So, 所以这个开示呢，里面包含两个层次。好，那第一个层次是关于个人的一个层次。那在个人的层次方面，我们必须要这个提升我们自己，那然后呢，我们的这个身跟语的这一个业呢，才能够慢慢的变得清净，善，然后符合道德哦。那 in essence, we should make ourselves a better person. 所以重点呢，就是我们要让我们自己呢变一个成为一个好人哦。No one is perfect. There is always room for improvement. 所以我们都不是圣贤者，所以我们永远都会有这样的一个进步的一个空间。On the social level, we need to also bear in mind the well-being of others and endeavor to bring benefit to all sentient beings. 所以在这个在社会的这个层面呢，那我们应该要经常记在心里面，就是我们应该时常想到这个众生的一个安乐哦，然后带给一切众生利益。 So the spirit of Mahayana practice encompasses our own personal development as well as the development of our society. 所以这个大乘佛教的精神的一个实践呢，它包含了我们个人的一个提升，以及这个社会的一个成长。So then, how or where do we begin? I would like to use Queen Sri Mana's 10 great vows to show how we can begin, bring the spirit of Mahayana into our lives. 所以那么我们应该要从哪里如何开始呢？那接下来呢？我个人想要用这个圣曼夫人的这个十大愿呢，来作为一个例子，来让大家了解如何把这个大圣的这个精神呢带到我们的一个生活当中。Queen Sri Mala, first of all, I'd like to give you a background of Queen Sri Mala. Queen Sri Mala is the daughter of King Prasenajit and Queen Malika. 圣曼夫人她是这个波斯匿王以及这个莫莉夫人的一个女儿。In Sramana Devi Sutra, it recounts that King Prasenajit and Queen Malika, who were devout disciples of the Buddha, wanted to arouseTheir daughter's interest in the Buddha and his great teachings. So they sent a messenger with a letter praising the infinite merits of the Buddha. 这个波斯匿王呢跟这个莫莉夫人她是一个很虔诚的这个佛弟子，那他们希望能够引发他女儿这个圣曼夫人的这一个对佛法的一个兴趣啊，所以有一天呢他派了一个使者带了一封信，那这封信是赞美佛这个无量的功德。Upon reading the letter, Queen Sri Mala was able to establish unshakable faith in the Buddha, and as the time was right, the Buddha appeared before her and told her the Dharma. 所以当这个圣曼夫人读了这封信之后呢，那她马上就升起一个这个不动的这个信心啊，然后呢对这个佛法升起这个不动的一个信心。然后当这个因缘成熟的时候呢，那佛陀就出现在他面前，然后教导他这个法。She then made 10 great vows to practice the path always. Queen Sri Mala's 10 great vows are something we can all learn from, and if we reflect on them in detail, we can see that they all accord with the spirit of Mahayana. 所以当这个圣曼夫人听了这个法之后呢，那她就发了十个大愿啊，那她发愿她永远这个实践这个道这个法。那这圣曼夫人这十个大愿呢，那她基本上是我们可以用来学习，并且在我们生活中反省。如果我们能够详细的用这些她的愿来反省我们自己呢，那我们可以看到这些愿基本上它就是一个大圣佛法精神的一个代表。When I first read these vows, I was very moved by the compassion, determination, and faith underlying them. 当我个人第一次读到这一个愿的时候，那个人感到非常的感动，那对他这个慈悲还有这个坚定还有这个信心呢隐含在这个愿背后的这一些意涵。 All her 10 vows begin with the promise to uphold these practices from now on until she attains enlightenment, which refers to Buddhahood in this case. 在她的这个十大愿里面呢，那她一开始的这个内容都是他发愿从现在乃至于他成这个正觉，那他都要这个时时刻刻来这个实践他这样的一个愿那这个正觉就是他成佛To be able to make such a promise is the sign of her determination and faith in the teachings of the Buddha and her compassion towards all sentient beings. 所以能够发这样的一个愿呢，那表示着她的一种决心，还有她的一个信心，并且也显示她对众生的一种慈悲心。As some of you may know, in Mahayana teaching, attainment of Buddhahood takes a very long time and spans hundreds and thousand lifetimes. 可能在座有些人可能知道，就是要成就佛道，那他需要花很长很长的时间，一般来说了，要花好几生的一个时间。Following her example in our daily lives, we can also try to make vows within our current capacity. 所以我们可以依循了她的这一些例子呢，然后在我们的生活上也经常的去发愿，然后去实践，并且这个愿呢必须要符合我们现在所能做到的一个能力，要不然太高我们做不到。For example, vow to do at least one good deed each day, or vow to tackle a certain bad habit, vow to learn a new skill,etc. 所以我们可以发一些简单的愿，比如说我们每天做一件好事情，或者是呢我们就是每天去对治一个坏的一个习惯，或者是学一个新的一个技术。 Making vows has the effect of planting within us the seeds for future success in our practice. 所以这个发这个愿呢，它有这样的一个功效，就是把这个种子未来成功的种子呢种到我们这个身心当中。 It also helps to change our mindset from I can't do into I will door I must do. 所以这也可以帮助我们改变我们的一个心态。我们一般我们都觉得这个太难，我们做不到。如果我们能够经常发愿呢，那慢慢慢慢的我们会改变我们心态。然后从我没办法做到呢，变成我将要做到，或者是我必须要做到，然后有这样的一个决心。Of course, the goal of our vow should be wholesome and lofty. 当然了，我们这个愿一定要这个是善的，而且是高尚，然后不能说每天要发愿要做一些坏事，这个不行。If we keep going like this, then one day, maybe even in this life,we can have the courage to adopt Queen Sri Mara's vows as our own. 所以如果我们能够持续这样的一个练习或是实践呢，那我们慢慢慢慢总有一天呢甚至可能是这一生，我们有这样的一个勇气，然后以这个圣曼夫人这样的愿呢作为我们的一个愿。 Okay, due to time constraints, I will only cover the main points of each vows, but I do encourage you all to read through all her vows and reflect on them deeply as they are all very beautiful. 所以由于时间的关系，那我只重点的跟大家做一些分享，但是呢很鼓励大家能够去读这个圣曼夫人这四个大愿并且呢用它们来作为我们日常修行的一个反省。基本上这个四个大愿是非常的美。Now let's look at her vows and how we can try to practice them ourselves and fulfill the Mahayana spirits. 好，那接下来我们就来看她这个十个愿，然后也让大家了解如何把这一个她的愿呢应用在我们生活中，也乃至于如何让这个我们生活的实践能够符合大圣的一个精神。 Okay, first, her first vow is that she will not violate the discipline. What this means is she vows to uphold the precepts with utmost purity. 第一个愿呢，她发愿她不去违反这个戒法哦。那这个意的里面的一个意涵呢，就是说他发愿他要奉持这个戒，以这个最清净的一个方式来奉行这样的一个戒。Okay, she won't even think a bad thought, even more so, she won't carry out any bad deeds that create harm.Either by bodily actions or speech. 他在这个院里面呢，他甚至呢连一个这种不善的念呢，他都不让他去升起，并且他也不去做一些伤害众生的事情，不管是身体的或是语言上的。Some people uphold the precepts and don't carry out bad deeds, but in their minds, they may still get angry and curse others or indulge in impure thoughts. 所以有些人他可能他在这个身口这样的一个戒行上是很清净的，但是他内心呢还是会有一些这个生气啦，或者是诅咒别人啊，虽然看不到，或者是里面内心沉浸在这种不善的这一些念头里面。Okay, to vow to keep one's mind pure is a great gift to all beings, the gift of no harm and fearlessness. 所以能够这个让我们心呢保持这个清净，它是一个很伟大的一个礼物，对众生来说。那什么样的礼物？就是让众生没有恐惧。If you know a person will not harm you, not even in their thoughts, then you need not fear them. This is the precious gift of fearlessness, isn't it? 所以当我们知道一个人他是一个不会去伤害别人的人，乃至于他的内心也都不会去伤害别人，那我们跟这样的一个人在一起的时候，我们内心就不会有任何的一个恐惧。 For our own practice, we should aspire to uphold this vow. It may seem impossible for some at this moment, but if we work at it step by step, we can divide and conquer. 所以这样的一个愿呢可能对某些人来讲他是有困难的，因为他要连内心都没有任何一点这种恶念呢，他好像很困难，但是我们可以慢慢的来做，一步一步来。那有一个 English 的一个的这个 saying 就是 divide and conquer， 所以我们可以就是一点一点的去做，然后终有一天他就会成功。First weStart by learning the precepts and progressively uphold them. 所以首先呢，我们先去学习这个戒法的内容，然后一步一步慢慢的去奉持这些戒。For lay practitioners, Buddha set forth the 5 precepts, and these can grow to 8 precepts, or even the 10 precepts if one takes on short-term monastic retreat.所以对这个在家居士而言呢，那佛陀就施设这个五戒，乃至于更精进的呢就奉持这个八戒，或者是有人参加这个短期的出家，那他可以奉行这个十戒。Let's take a quick look at the 5 precepts, which are no killing, no stealing, no sexual misconduct, no harmful speech, and no taking of intoxicants. 这五戒的内容呢，它就是这个不杀，然后不盗，然后不邪淫，然后 这个不妄语啊，还有这个在中文不饮酒，但是在英文呢，就是不要去这一个使用这一个麻醉品啊，这个酒烟这些都是啊。These precepts are really a guide for uplifting our human character. They are not purely something for Buddhists. You don't have to be Buddhist to live by these wholesome ways. 所以这些这个五戒的内容，它基本上就是一种生活的一个指南。哦，那而且是能够让我们的这个人类的品德提升，哦，那所以我们不需要是一个佛教徒，那这些五戒的一个实践一个奉行基本上是对我们是友好的，哦，那所以我们不需要是个佛教徒，我们一样可以来奉行这个五戒的内容。 So when we talk about keeping the precepts, we first learn to tame ouractions and speech and mental activities. We will fall back along the way. That is natural, but if we persist, eventually we can become purer and the morality becomes a habit. 所以当我们这个要奉行这些戒法呢，首先我们需要去这个调伏我们这个身语意，哦，然后呢，当然在这过程当中我们会退却，哦，就是回到原来的一个状态，但是这个是一个很自然的一个过程，哦，所以我们只要能够坚持，那最后呢我们能够变得更清净，然后呢这个我们这个戒呢，戒体也会，这个戒善呢会变成我们的一个习惯，哦，One who is habitually moral will not violate the discipline, even in their thoughts. 所以当一个人他这些戒的一个善呢变成是一种习惯的时候，那他就不会去违反这些戒法，乃至于他在心里面的一种违反他都不会有。How wonderful it would be if everyone was habitually moral in mind, actions and speech. 所以大家可以想一想，这个是多么美妙的一个世界啊！所以每个人都能够这个养成这种善的一个习惯，然后这个展现在他的身口意上面。Okay, let's look at her second vow. In her second vow, she says she will be respectful to the venerable elders. Venerable elders can include our teachers, parents, seniors, and so on. 在她的第一个愿呢，她发愿她要尊敬一切的这个尊长，哦，那这个尊长呢，它包含我们的师长，我们的父母亲，哦，乃至我们比我们年长的这一些人等等，哦，These people have kindly shared with us their knowledge or skills, which in turn enriches our own character. For this, we should be grateful and respectful towards them. 那我们为什么要尊敬这一刚刚我们谈到这些尊长呢？那因为呢，他们在我们的成长过程当中，他们分享他们的知识啊，等或是他们的一个技术，那这一些呢，让我们这个品德能够提升。那因为这样的一个缘故呢，那我们就基本上我们就应该要这个心存感谢，哦，乃至于尊敬这些人。Respecting others means to have consideration for their feelings, wishes, rights, and traditions. 所以尊重他人呢，它包含的就是对他人的这些感受啊，哦，希望啊，还有他的这一个权利或是他的一个传承能够予以尊重，哦，或是予以考量。 Our actions and behavior should acknowledge and value others and not belittle them. 所以我们这一个行为呢， 以需要这一个 去感谢以及去重视他人、哦、并且呢不能去轻视他人。 OK, Her third and fourth vows are very important and very much needed at the present time. 在接下来这个第三个跟第四个愿呢非常重要，特别是我们这个现代这个社会对第三第四个愿是很重要的、哦、She vows to not hate living beings and not hold jealousy towards them. 她发愿她不要对这个众生 不要有这个不会有嗔恨心乃至于这个嫉妒心。Hate and jealousy is a vice that erodes away at humanity. It eats away at our compassion and can lead to acts of violence and destruction, bringing much suffering to ourselves and others. 基本上这个嗔恨呢跟这个嫉妒它是一种邪恶的，是坏的，那它会这个侵蚀我们这一个人的这一种道德性，并且会腐蚀我们的这个慈悲心，以及并且呢会引发这种暴力的行为，毁坏的行为，然后带给众生以及我们自己呢更多这样的一个苦难、哦、So we see this with all the fighting and the wars that are happening today. 我们可以看到今天很多这个战争然后是这个彼此这个对的这个争斗呢、哦、都含着这一些内容、哦、If humans can put down this hatred and jealousy, can you imagine what this world would be like? 所以当我们能够放下这些嗔恨跟这个嫉妒呢，那大家想一想他这个我们的世界会变得如何的一个美妙、哦 okay, sometimes when you come across a person or a group of people that you dislikeIt is hard to control the negative emotions that arise inside. 有时候我们会遇到一些很不喜欢的人，那我们内心总会有一些这个不欢喜的情绪，那这个有时候也很难避免。But if we know that our temper is not so good, we can try to learn ways to tame it and tone it down. 所以当我们知道我们脾气不好，那我们平常就要有一些练习、哦、那当遇到状况的时候我们就能够化险为夷、哦、In the midst of anger and jealousy, we can say or do things that hurt others, and often we end up regretting it ourselves. 所以当我们在这个愤怒或是嫉妒的一个当中呢，那我们会说一些这种伤害他人或是做出伤害他人的一些行为，那最后呢，伤害是我们自己、哦、我们会变得很懊悔。If we put in effort to control our temper, reduce hatred and jealousy, we will definitely be much happier, and the people around us will also share in the benefit. 所以如果我们能够努力呢 去这个调伏我们这个情绪脾气、哦、然后减少我们这种嫉妒跟嗔恨，那我们将我们一定会变得更快乐，那在我们身边的这一些人呢也可以分享到这样的一个利益、哦、So how to tackle hatred and jealousy? The answer is compassion kindness and patience. 所以，我们要如何去这个调伏我们这个不好的这些情绪呢？脾气呢？那这一个慈悲啊，去学习慈悲，compassion 啊，慈心、悲心，还有这一个耐心啊，那它是一个很重要的这一个钥匙，让我们能够改变我们不好的一个脾气啊。Compassion and hatred are the exact opposites, just like the light and darkness. 基本上这个这个慈心啊，哦，然后慈悲心呢，它跟这个嗔恨还有嫉妒，它基本上是相对的，哦，就是相反的，哦，有慈悲就没有嗔恨，有嗔恨就不会有慈悲，它就像这个白天跟黑暗，哦，势不两立。 OK, where one exists, the other cannot. So if you fill your mind with compassion and kindness, it will be very hard for hatred to take hold.Patience is also needed because in trying to control our temper, sometimes we become impatient with ourselves. And when we think it too hard or impossible, we may want to give up. 耐性呢，或是这个忍，他对我们的一个修行，就是调伏我们这一个情绪呢，是很重要的哈，因为我们有时候会因为这个我们遇到事情太过于困难哦，所以会变得很没有耐性，甚至呢想要去放弃。But try to be patient, give ourselves time to change.For the better. The whole process of purifying our minds and behavior takes time. Indeed, in Mahayana teachings, it takes many lifetimes to perfect ourselves. So patience is very important.所以请大家一定要去培养这个耐心啊，让我们给我们自己一些时间啊。那基本上整个这个进化我们自己这个过程呢，它是需要这个很多很多生很多世的啊。那所以呢，给我们这个时间去这个圆满我们自己。所以呢，因此呢，这个耐心忍呢，是非常重要的一个修行的一个德目。Okay, let's look at the fifth vow and sixth vow. And in the previous four vows, her first four vows focus on self-purification, which then flow on into her actions and speech. And we see this in the remaining vows. In her fifth vow, she says, even if she has little, she will not be stingy. And so, in her sixth vow,Whatever she has, she is willing to use it to assist living beings. 在前面这四个愿里面呢，基本上它是一种自我的一个进化，哦，然后呢，接着下来呢，就是要展现在这个身跟语这方面，哦，那在接下来的这个愿呢，我们都可以看得到。那在第五个愿呢，他说他纵使他只有一点点啊，一点点东西，那他也不会吝啬，他愿意分享，如果有人需要的话。因此呢，在这个第六个愿，他就说呢，不论他有什么，那他都愿意去用这些他所拥有的一点东西来帮助众生啊。I don't know if you have met such people.Probably difficult, but I have observed that for some people, charity is only something they think about when they feel they have enough all are secure. 所以我不知道大家有没有遇过这样的一种人哈，那种菩萨哈。但是我有观察到一般的人呢，那就是当他们就是富，就是这个充足了，或是觉得这个他们财富已经达到一个安全的这样的一个地步呢，他们会去做一些慈善啊。This is not bad. At least they do give rise to sort of helping others, right?But in comparison, some people who themselves are poor are still very willing to do charity or help others. It is obvious which of the two has greater virtues. 所以虽然刚刚我们讲到说，当我们大部分人都是我们都有一点都就是生活已经稳定了，那我们才会想到去帮助别人做一些慈善。但虽然这不是很完美，但是也不错了哈，也不错。至少他们会去想到别人哈，然后去帮助别人。但是呢，如果跟这一些这个能够有这种无私的这种去分享的这些人来比的话，如果跟这些人来比的话，那大家应该可以很清楚的知道说，谁的功德比较大哈，This virtue of generosity can help to build many good karmic relations between sentient beings. This is the type of wealth we should be seeking. 所以这个慷能够这个慷慨的布施呢，能够让我们跟众生建立一个很好的这一种业缘关系啊。然后这样，其实这样的一种财富，就是说我们跟众生建立这样的一个好的关系呢，是我们应该要去追寻，然后去建立的。Moreover, if we practice generosity sincerely, it can also help erode away attachment to ourselves and our possessions, which means we experience less pain when we have to part with things we cherish. 所以这样的一种就经常去慷慨去做布施呢，去帮助去给别人把我们的东西施予给别人啊，如果我们能够这个很诚心诚意来实践这样的一个这个修行呢，那它可以让我们帮助我们渐渐的呢除去我们这个执着。我们佛教说要去除执着嘛，去除对自己的执着，还有对我们这个拥有这些东西的一个执着。那换句话说呢，那我们可以经验到我们会减少我们的一些痛苦。当我们跟这些珍惜的东西要分离的时候，我们会减少一些痛苦。好，In terms of benefiting others, I feel that the seventh vow is a practical guide we can use. She vows to practice the four all-embracing virtues, which are giving, kind speech, beneficial deeds, and cooperation. 关于这个利益他人或是利益众生的一个实践呢，那个人觉得他第七个愿他非常的实用哦，那可以当作我们的一个指南。那他发愿呢，去这个实践这个四four embracing， 这叫什么？哎。Can someone help me? I can't remember the Chinese. 四摄法 ，Thank you very much. Thank you. 就是实践这个四摄法哦，那它就是这一个布施、爱语，然后这一个力行，还有这个同事。The four all-embracing virtues can be practiced by anyone, anywhere, and anytime. 所以这四摄法呢，我们任何人呢都可以去实践它，在任何的时间、任何的地方。Giving does not have to be material. We can give by leading a helping hand, offering a ear to hear them out, providing a shoulder to cry on, and so on. 所以这个布施呢，不一定要是物质的哈、哦。那我们可以给别人一个帮助哈、哦，简单的帮助，或是这个倾听啊、哦、别人的一些心事啊、哦，或者是提供一个肩膀哈、哦，让别人要哭的时候可以在我们的肩膀上哭哈、哦，等等之类的啊。In terms of kind speech, we can be as simple as having good manners, saying please and thank you. 所以关于这个爱语呢，我们可以很简单的去做一些，我们容易做到，比如说，要希望别人帮忙，我们就说一个请啊、哦，等等，或者是当别人帮助过我们时过之后呢，那我们感谢人家，说声谢谢啊。哦Or it can be more deep in terms of giving encouragement, good advice, and refraining from saying things that curse, that cause harm or incite hatred and so on.如果以更深层的一个实践这个爱语来说呢，那我们可以给其他人这个鼓励啊，或是好的这个建议，或者是呢，让或者是这个远离这一些这种产生这种伤害，或是引发这种愤怒的这一些。说这些话、哦、或是避免说这些话、哦、beneficial deeds bring forth the compassion and kindness in our hearts and turn them into actions. 例行呢、它能够把这一个慈悲呢、带到我们这个内心里面，然后转化成这个实际的一个行动啊，也就是将我们这个内心这个慈悲呢转化成行动。Really get out there and do things that benefit others and make others truly happy. In the process, you will often find yourselves filled with happiness too. 所以当我们在帮助别人的过程当中呢，我们会发现其实我们也得到很多的快乐、哦、Lastly, cooperation. This is the key to reducing arguments and nurturing harmony. Cooperation is in a workplace is different to cooperation in the home, among friends, and so forth. 那最后呢是这个同事哦、那同事他是一个很重要的一种实践，他能够减少在我们在人与人之间的这一种纷争、哦、那并且能够促进这种和谐。那这种同事呢，在不同的场合会有不同的一个实践方式、哦、在办公室或在家里跟朋友之间呢，他都会有所不同。Although at times they are different positions of authority, we can practice respect for others and their position as well as work together in a manner that reflects equality. This is how we can manifest cooperation. 所以我们如何来实践这个同事呢？基本上我虽然我们在这个生活当中每个人都有不同的一个职位、哦、那我们可以一起工作，一种平等的这样的一个心呢跟其他人一起工作。比如说假设我们是上司的话，那我们对待我们这个部署呢就是好像朋友这样，不要把他当我们下面的人、哦、那这个呢就其实就是一种同事的一个实践、哦、Sometimes we need to take a lead and do it responsibly. Sometimes we need to listen and follow others and do it respectfully. 所以有时候呢，我们必须要这个担任这个领导，然后负责任去做一些事。那有时候不该出头的时候就不要出头，就听从人家的这一个指示呢，然后去做人家要我们做的，用一种恭敬心来完成人家对于我们的这一些交付我们的一些任务。In Mahayana spirit, in the Mahayana spirit, the practice of the four all-embracing virtues aims to bring true benefit to sentient beings. The mindset accompanying this practice is just as her vows stipulate, andDo it with sincerity, never tiring, and without prejudice. 所以这一个，当我们这一个这种习惯性的思考呢，能够伴随这样的一个实践呢，就如同他的这个愿一样，那实践他就是在做的时候呢，用一种诚恳的心啊，然后不会有懈怠，也不会有这样的一种傲慢啊，不会有这样的一种傲慢。Okay, let's look at her eighth vow. Her eighth vow, which I find very I find her eighth vow is now let's turn to her eighth vow, which I find very moving. Here she clearly identifies those who need help and the most, need help the most, being that are lonely, imprisoned, ill, facing many hardships. This essentially means anyone who is in suffering, whether mentally or physically or economically, she will help them and never give up on them until they find peace and happiness again. 关于他这个第八个愿呢，我个人感到非常的一个感动哈。那他很清楚的去定义那一些最需要帮助的一个人哈。那哪一些人呢？那一些这个孤独的人，或者是受到这个禁闭的人，或者是生病，或者是面对很多这种困难的人哈。这个愿呢，它基本上它所要告诉我们的概念就是，任何人当他遭遇到痛苦的时候，不管是他在精神上的痛苦，或是身体上的痛苦，或者是这个经济上的一个痛苦，那他都呢愿意这个帮助他这些人，也永远不会放弃他们，一直到他们找到这个平静以及快乐啊。This may sound very lofty, and we may say, "I can't do it, I can't do that," but we can. 这个愿听起来好像非常的远大哈。那我们可能会说，没办法做得到。但事实上，我们是可以的哈。Some people are very proactive and seek out ways to help others. For example, they volunteer at charities that provide services to the elderly, homeless, etc., or even approach their local nursing homes and offer to come and talk to the residents, play games with them, give them some company and attention, make them feel appreciated. 所以有些人他是非常的积极，然后 去寻求不同的方法去利益他人。例如呢，有些人他们在这些慈善机构做义工，那他们就去帮助一些年长的人啊，或者是没有家的人，或是到一些地方上这些nursing home， 这边中文怎么讲？nursing 就是那个老人院 ，OK，Thank you， 去这个老人院然后去陪他们玩啊，陪他们聊天等等But if we don't have that much energy or time, we can still practice this vow by being prepared and willing to help when the situation arises. 所以可能我们没有那么多的精力到老人院去整天陪他们那我们一样呢，可以就是这一个发小一点的愿也就是说我们可以做一些准备哪一天这个情况适合的时候，那我们就可以去利益其他人。For example, if our friendly family members or friends fall sick, we can give to help them, give them a helping hand, look after them, or look after their children, or help them with household chores if they are injured. Little things like that we can do if we put our mind to it.所以我们其实可以做的事情还蛮多的啦比如说我们这个家人或是朋友如果生病的时候那我们可以给他们一些帮助或者是帮他们照顾小孩啊等等或当他们这个受伤的时候去帮他们做一些家务事比如说洗碗啊拖地啊等等所以这个一些小小事情都是我们可以去做的。Here I would like to point out that the term in prison does not have to relate to jail. Of course, if we have the ability to help people in jail turn over a new leaf, that is wonderful. But if we don't have those skills yet, in prison can also be interpreted as those who feel trapped or are trapped in a difficult situation. Okay, 所以在这边要跟大家这个说明这一个禁闭在他的院里面他要去帮助这些被禁闭的人。那禁闭呢他不一定是被关在牢里面那当然我们有这样的一个能力呢可以去帮助被关在牢里面的人能够出来获得新生那这个是非常好的如果我们没有这样的一个技术技巧呢那其实这些禁闭呢他我们可以把它诠释为就是那一些就是陷入困境的人就被禁闭在一些困境里面Trapped can also relate to animals. I know in Australia, there are animal shelters that always welcome volunteers to come play with the animals, like taking the dogs for a walk. Otherwise, the dogs have to stay locked in their kennels. 所以这个禁闭不只是人这个动物也是我们可以去帮助的那我像个人之前在澳洲学习，那知道澳洲有那这个动物的这个庇护所那就很多这个义工到这个动物的这个避难所呢，去跟这些动物玩，带他们去走一走如果不去带他们出来走，他们就被关在笼子里面Can you see what I'm trying to express? If they are people or sentient beings out there that we know need help, we should try our best to help them or find someone who has the skills or ability to help them. 所以希望大家能够理解刚刚所说的这一些要点就是说 当我们遇到一些需要帮助的一些众生的时候呢，那我们应该尽我们所能去帮助他，或者当我们能力不足，我们找个人去帮助哈，找我们有能力的人去帮助他们。The end of this vow also highlights an important Buddhist practice, which is non-attachment. 那这个愿呢的最后呢，它强调一个佛法。佛教里面的一个实践就是，没有执着这样的一个实践啊。We see this in her last sentence. She says, "Only then will I leave them." 就是说，她去帮助一些人，帮助完之后不是跟他们黏在一起，就是帮助完他们成长之后，再去帮助其他需要帮助的人，所以就是不要有那种执着，那种情执这样子。In Mahayana teachings, as we progress, we also need to learn to let go. After we help someone, and they are free from their sufferings, we too need to learn to move on. You may think that this is easy to do, but sometimes we can get very attached to the people or beings we help. So when the time come to part, we find it hard to let go. Being able to let go will help reduce the sadness that comes with separation. 所以在这样的一个实践呢，非常的重要啊，就是说，但是可能有些人会觉得这样就是放下是很容易的，或者说帮助别人之后就忘了，有时候不是那么容易忘掉哈，有时候付出感情啊，所以当这个离别的时刻呢，那我们有时候会觉得这个很辛苦啊，会觉得很伤心哈。所以呢，能够这个，如果我们能够去这个帮助别人啊，能够去实践这个放下呢，那它基本上可以帮助我们减少这些悲伤哈。当我们跟这些人分别的时候，here I would like to give you an example which happened. It's my friend's story. It's real story, not a creative story. A friend I know who volunteered to help train a guide dog. After a year with the dog, he became very fond of it and was very sad when he had to return it back to the guide dog association. But on a happy ending, the dog failed the test because it was too active. So my friend was given the first option to take it back as the pet. Of course, he jumped at that offer. 所以这个朋友他之前是帮一个这个导盲犬的一个这个协会训练他当这个义工。当人跟狗有时候这个感情有时候会很深所以一年之后当他训练完之后就要送回这个协会他就觉得很难过，因为他很喜欢这只狗。结果呢，这只狗没有通过那个导盲的这个测验所以最后那个协会就问他说要不要这一只狗，因为他是第一优先的那他那时候就跳起来高兴得不得了。所以这可以看到他这个情执在里面。OK。Her last two vows, number 9 and 10, are very long. I will only talk about them partially. In her 9th vow, she focuses on he focuses on changing people's destructive behaviors, namely acts of killing or violations against the precepts. 在最后这他的第九个愿跟第十个愿他非常的长，那这边就只能扼要的跟大家做一些分享。那在他第九个愿呢，他主要是着重在改变一些人们众生一些这种破坏性的一些行为或者是哪一些呢，就是比如说是那一些杀生的这些行为或者是这个违反这个戒法的这些行为。From this, we can see the spirit of Mahayana does not give up on being, even if they have done bad things. For some, they don't even realize what they are doing is not so good. For example, when we say killing is bad, many immediately think of the crime murder, but we fail to think about the local butcher and the fishmonger. 这有点长哈，所以从这个愿我们可以看到这个大乘佛教的一个精神啊哈，也就是说，当佛教不放弃任何的众生，乃至于这种不好的众生，那佛我们都不会去放弃他们哈。那比如说呢，当我们讲到这个杀生是不好的哈，那大部分人都会想到说，就是一些杀人犯啊哈，但事实上呢，大家都没有想到那个杀生还包含杀动物啊，杀动物，比如说这个在这个市场里面这个杀猪杀牛的啦，或者是这个卖鱼的等等之类啊。So we fail to think about the local butchers and fishmonger. They make a living out of killing each day, and it is legal. 所以基本上这些做杀生事业人呢，那他们每天靠这个生活，但是他们是合法的。那我们通常不会想到这些。Then you have those involved in the game hunting. They kill for fun, chasing and hunting down wild animals. Can you imagine the fear these animals experience and the injuries they may suffer during the hunt, and then the pain at the point of death? 所以这边想要跟大家分享就是说，其实我们对动物也应该要这个慈悲啦齁。所以当我们这个有些人，他们像有些俱乐部，他会以这个打猎当作他们这个娱乐齁。那他们会伤害这些众生。那大家想一想，当这些众生被这些追杀的时候，内心的恐惧有多大齁。然后他们所受到的伤害啊，乃至于那种痛苦，在这个最后死亡那个痛苦是非常深啊，非常深的啊。Queen Sri Mala says she will restrain those that need to be and assist those that need it. If we look deeper, restraining someone from committing acts of killing and harm, brings benefit to both the doer and the victim. 所以这个圣曼夫人呢，她发愿她要这个减少这一些啊，减少这一些并且呢协助这一些人能够去做一些善的这一些业啊，正命啊。那如果我们能够看得更深入一点呢，那其实去限制这一些人做这一些杀业以及这个伤害呢，能够带给他们这个利益啊，不论是这个造作者或者是这个被受害者，都能够让他们得到利益。 By restraining the doer, they can reduce the amount of bad karma they create, which means less suffering in their future. For the potential victims, they get relief straight away because the danger of harm is no longer there.所以能够限制这一些杀生杀业的这一些行为呢，那它可以这个减少这个造作者他造作这个恶业哦，那这个换句话说，他在未来呢就可以少受一点苦报哦，那对这一个受害者呢哦，那他们也可以直接的呢得到这一些就是不会被伤害啊，不会因为呢这一些危险或是伤害呢已经不会再存在了。 So the spirit of Mahayana incorporates equality. When we talked about benefiting others, this includes humans and other beings. Where we can, we should try to reduce the amount of harm that humans inflict on other animals as well. 所以这个大乘佛教的精神呢，它就是有这种平等性啊，平等心啊。那当我们讲到这个利益众生呢，那基本上要包含人类跟这个动物了啊。那所以我们只要能够做到呢，那我们就尽量能够去减少这些伤害啊，这些人类对这个其他动物的伤害也是如此啊。We can even take this further and extend to include the environment. 所以我们也可以把这样的一种不要去伤害他人哦，扩展到我们所生活的这个环境哦，有情的、无情的都一样，因为这环境破坏，我们也会受到一些伤害啊。On the other important note, in this vow, we also see that she recognizes her present abilities are limited.So she vows that when she does have the ability, she will do this. 所以在这个愿里面呢，我们看到另外一个重点，就是说她了解到她目前所具足的这个能力哦，所以呢，她就说当他有这个能力的时候呢，那他就他发愿他能够做他所发愿要做的事情啊。Likewise, it is important that we know our own abilities, and although at times we should challenge ourselves so that we can progress, but we should avoid getting in over our heads.That means we need to recognize what level we are at. Are we in a position to help? Are we capable of helping? Sometimes we need to step back, otherwise we can make the situation worse or end up being the one that needs help, right?So a classical example is rescuing someone drowning in water. If we have the ability, then you jump in and get them out. If we don't, we should call for help. Otherwise, we may end up drowning as well. 所以当我们在帮助他人的时候呢，我们必须要考虑到我们所目前还具足有哪一些能力啊，那要不然超出我们能力范围呢，那我们可能会泥菩萨过江啊，自身难保，所以这一点我们也是需要去考虑的啊。Okay, last vow. In her in this last vow, we are shown the chain of events that could happen if we forget the true Dharma. Here, she is referring to the ultimate truth. Only by awakening to and fully penetrating this truth does one become a Buddha. 在第四个愿呢，那他发愿，他不要去忘记这个法哦。那这里面他所这个指涉的这个法呢，是这一个诸法实相哦。他发愿不要去忘记这个诸法实相哦。那为什么？因为当我们能够这个体悟这个诸法实相呢，那我们才能够成佛哦，才能够成佛。Thus, by embracing it and not forgetting it, she is referring to the goal of Buddhahood. If she loses sight of her goal, she will not have the motivation or aspiration to practice the path. 所以当如果他这个失去这个目标的时候呢，那他也会失去这个动力、哦、然后去这个实践这个成佛的这个修行、哦、If she doesn't practice the path of the Mahayana and cultivate the perfections, she willNot reap the fruit of Buddhahood. Hence, she explains that if one does not aspire to the Mahayana, they will not be able to transcend the level of common people.所以如果他没有这个实践这个大圣的道，或者是修行这个波罗蜜呢，那他就没有办法去收成这个成佛的这个果实哦。因此他解释呢，就是说如果他没有这个发愿去向这个大圣的佛道呢，那他将没有办法这个超越这种凡夫的这样的一个层次、哦、凡夫的一个层次。Here, perfections refer to the paramitas, which are the practices of giving, morality, endurance, or tolerance, diligence, concentration, or meditation.And insight or wisdom, most of you may heard of this. 所以这个在这里面的这个波罗蜜就是指这个六波罗蜜哦，那它就是这个布施、施罗哦、戒波罗蜜、忍波罗蜜、精进波罗蜜、禅定波罗蜜跟智慧波罗蜜。If one cultivates the paramitas, this is planting the seed. 如果我们实践这个波罗蜜呢，那基本上我们是在播下一个种子。When these are perfected, one reaps the fruit of Buddhahood. If one loses sight of goal of Buddhahood, then the motivation to practice is not there.Hence, making it hard to transcend the level of the common people. 所以这个就是一个循环的链啊，就是说，当我们能够圆满的，那我们就能够享受，就能够丰收这个成佛的果实。那如果这个我们这个失去这个成佛这个目标呢，哦。那我们就会失去我们这个 motivation， 我们这个动力、哦、然后去实践，那我们就没办法超越这个凡夫的一个层次、哦、Here, common people is not meant to be derogatory. It is just that from a spiritual aspect, the common human lives.is full of suffering and imperfections, while the level of Buddhas is peaceful, calm, and perfect. 所以这里面这个凡夫他 并没有这个贬义、哦、就是说他就是跟这个佛来比较、哦、那他就是充满了这个苦、哦、充满了这个苦。那因为佛呢，他是充满这种平静啊，哈、哦，以及这个圆满，佛是个圆满的一个觉悟者。In her final vow, she is affirming the underlying force to keep her on the Mahayana path. That is the goal of Buddhahood. Only by holding tight to this vision does one continue to live and breathe the Mahayana spirit, continually making themselves a better person, as well as bring benefit to others.所以在他的这一个最后一个愿呢，那他就是发愿能够坚持这个大圣的这个佛道哦，因为呢，只有这一个对这个目标呢，我们能够这个很坚定的去这一个去把握这一个目标哦。那我们呢，才能够在生活里、呼吸里面都有这个大圣的这一个精神啊、哦，然后持续的呢，让我们变得更好啊、哦，并且呢，带给众生种种的利益。The ultimate benefit is to also help others to become perfect.To become Buddhas, 所以这个究竟的这个利益呢，也就是让所有众生都能够成佛哦。So I went through the material a bit quickly, given the time, but I hope that you can see the spirit of Mahayana and the path to Buddhahood is one that is filled with virtues.Goodness and purity. If we can incorporate this spirit into our lives and spread it into the community, it will be of much benefit to everyone. 所以以上呢，我们很快的把这个十个愿呢跟大家做一个分享、哦、那这个希望呢大家能够就是知道这个大圣佛教的一个精神、哦、并且呢明白这个成佛之道呢，它是这个充满了这个德性、善性跟清净性、哦、那让大家对这样的一个道呢充满了这个向往跟信心。因为所以如果我们能够把这个大乘佛教的一个精神呢融入在我们的这个生活里面呢，生命里面并且去把这个精神扩展到我们这个社会和、哦、社区，那它将会带给所有人，包含我们自己的利益、哦、If you would like to read up in more detail these 10 great vows and the sutra itself, there are two English translations available. One is from BDK, translated by Diana Paul. You can get the PDF version via this link. I will give the coordinator, you can get the link from coordinator. And another one is from Alex Hideko Wayman. I have consulted both versions. The vows presented largely borrow Diana Paul's translation with some of my own minor amendments here and there.So, finally, the final gifts to everyone. So I would like to end this talk with the saying I shared with you at the beginning. So, sincerely, may we be able to purify ourselves, our actions, speech, and thoughts. And in doing so,May we be able to bring benefit to all sentient beings. Thank you for your attention and have a good evening and safe trip home. Thank you.